show you some cool stuff here. See these here circles? Those there are bluegill beds. They're bedding in here, just chase them out. They guard the eggs in there, little bluegills. There's a whole bunch here. They came down here, fly or something small, pick a whole bunch of these bluegills out. They're big ones too, I was seeing. Maybe we'll hook into one. Alright, let's get it. Take a few casts here. Something went into the weeds. Usually they get off like that. Still be there. He is. You got a pile of weeds. Are here going crazy. The best ones chasing out that there duck. They just ruined my fishing. I don't know why that swan don't want to leave. There he goes. I know that duck don't want to leave. Swans are territorial. Let's see. They chased me out. I got too close. I know them though. I see the same creatures now and then. I get to know who you are. More observant than you think. Oh, you missed that. That's a good jump. Oh, he took another jump. Little guy. Oh. And I need pliers for him. I think these gotta be 18 inches, 2 feet. But we let them go. This is a silver rapala from the Fala, whatever you like to call them. Number 11. I like this size. You'll hit some big fish with it too. But a lot of small ones around. Alright, we're gonna get out of here, try another spot, look around, and take a walk. I just got in this spot, I just lost a beauty. It looked like about a 5-6 pound pickerel. And I turned on the camera, he took a beautiful jump, and got away. So we check this piece of water out and let's see what happens. I'm gonna try a top water in a little bit, I think. So, but I'm gonna work this first, wait for the sun to set a little, and see what we get. All right, let's see what happens. Pick one up. Not in weeds. A lot of weeds on there though. Oh boy. It was the big one, but we got him instead. This is what I'm using. I know it's a Yozori. I don't even know the name. I've had this for a long time. Probably over 10 years. This is I changed the hooks a few times. And it holds up well. It's a prop bait, so anything like that'll spin and you get a little motion and it makes a nice little ruckus. So that's what I like about these. And they're light and you can fish them on top of, you see the weeds. Work nice in this kind of situation. He's about 1/4 the size of the one that we lost. Let's get the pliers. Get them on. See if we could do a follow up. I like to do is keep a little belly in the line. Sometimes you see that fish and you pretend to strike before he takes it. But that belly, if you do that, you're picking up your slack and it gives him time to eat it. If he had a taste of that, I don't think he's coming back. Oh, God. Oh! He really smacked that good. Down in the weeds. I don't know where he is. Oh yeah, you got a good look at him, right? He's about one quarter the size of the one I lost. It's fun. I just want to get a good look at him, and you guys did too there, so you did okay. We're gonna let him go anyway, so. Probably could fish it out here till dark, and we'll probably pick up some more fish. But I'm gonna head back almost around where we started and finish up over there. I'm just curious how many fish pulled in that cove there this evening, and give that a shot. We'll take one or two more casts here, and then we'll move over there. About an hour of daylight left, so never know what we get, and let's see what happens. I should have stayed where I was. I definitely would have picked out a few more fish. And, there's nothing out there, Joe. But, well, nothing going on here, so I'm going to call it a night. Took a bunch of casts, tried top water, and then tried a little down, threw some crankbaits, and there's some activity, but, and not game fish. So, thanks for watching as always, and please subscribe to the channel. We'll have new videos soon, and if you can, take the time to like, dislike, and always love your comments, and remember, fish are away. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time.